Grandfather, please tell us the story of a fairy queen.
No, Grandfather. The story of a dinosaur.
No, Grandfather. I don't want that story.
Listen.
Please tell us the story of a snake with two mouths. Or a story of a frog. Huh?
No, Grandfather.
Something
different.
No, Grandfather.
Hey, stop. Listen to me. Listen to me, kids. Why are you making so much of noise? Listen to me and don't shout. Now listen. Today, I will not tell you any story.
No.
Listen to me. Let me complete. Don't scream. Today, I have brought a book of stories for you. Now, everyone has to read a story from this book for the others.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes, Grandfather.
So tell me one thing. Who's going to start?
I will read first.
Please, Grandfather.
Grandfather, I will read first.
Hey, kids. Hey, please listen to me. Don't speak amongst yourselves. Pay attention to him. Shubham, you may start now.
Wow, Shubham. Read it nicely,
Now listen. The name of the story is The Haughty Sculptor. It is a very old story. In a town, there lived a sculptor named Vidur.
He was famous as the best sculptor of the state. The statues made by him often appeared to be alive and were very popular in foreign countries also. He got many awards for his unsurpassable talent. But as his fame and wealth increased, he was swollen with pride.
My lord, this is Shakti Baba.
Okay.
Our King Suryasena's teacher.
I see.
King Suryasena wants you to make a statue of him.
Okay, I will. Please, sir, have a seat. Shakti Baba, I heard about you from King Suryasena. He personally told me that you can predict one's future perfectly.
I can tell you only what the lines on one's palms suggest.
Please tell me my future, sir. I mean, worldwide fame, uncountable wealth and respect. Other than this, if anything is there, please tell me, sir. Otherwise, please don't tell me.
While looking at Vidur, Shakti Baba immediately understood Vidur's haughtiness. He tried to advise him.
Vidur, always control your mind. You are a very good sculptor, but don't be lofty and priggish.
Please tell me my future, sir.
Yes, I will. No. Oh my God.
What's that?
No, nothing.
Nothing, sir? Then why did you exclaim like that, sir? Tell me what you have observed, sir.
Okay, son. Listen then. It's about your death. You have only 40 days left now. You will die on the 48th midnight from today.
Vidur was shocked by Shakti Baba's speech. He was restless by the thought of death. He started thinking how to avoid death. and he chalked out a plan to deceive Yama, the death god, by using his art. He made 6 statues of himself. These statues were so accurately made that no one could find him out if he stands in between them. This made him more conceited.
Death god Yama cannot find me out of all these statues. Even Death has to accept the defeat before my art.
At last, it was the night of death. The sculptor slept among the statues. Yama, the death god, came after some time and was shocked to see 7 sculptors sleeping.
Oh my god! How can I identify the real sculptor out of these 7? It's very difficult.
What will you do, sir, now? What I think is, better leave him for our next trip. Let us go now. We are already late.
Oh, nonsense! I can't do that. If you don't know anything, just shut up. I myself will deal with this matter here.
Very well, sir. But please get down. I have pain in my back and you are too heavy. And you are not ready to lose any weight.
Yama ignored him and started thinking. And suddenly he got an idea. With a beautiful smile on his face, he said,
"Great! Oh, sculptor! Very good! You have made 6 statues who looks exactly like you and you have confused me totally. But how can a great artist like you commit such a silly mistake? I can't understand."
When the sculptor heard this, he got up at once and asked,
"Mistake? And in my work? It's not possible only."
"Yes, this is your mistake. As I said, there is a mistake in statue. You got hurt and you got up. And this is your greatest and silly mistake. If you haven't done this mistake, then it was difficult for me to find you out of all these statues. So, let's go to the tour of heaven."
It's really hard to bear the pain and the pillion together.
Nice story.
Very nice.
Tell another one, please.
Sir, so kids, what have you learned from this story? Don't be lofty and priggish, because that will make you a loser. Haughtiness is one's biggest enemy.